Welcome to my Draw My Life video, Strawberryelectric48 edition, where I am going to illustrate for you, with my very limited whiteboard skills, my life. So, I was born on May 29th, 1995, to two amazing parents that I love to death, Paula and George. There's me and my little baby bundle. And there's my mom, and there's my dad, because he always wears a hat. It's not an Abraham Lincoln top hat, but it's usually a hat. And there's my brother, he's 2 years older than me, and he likes video games, so... So when I was born, my family lived in a condominium on the beach, but when I was 2 months old, those are some beautiful stairs, by the way, when I was 2 months old, we moved into our house that is also on the beach, and I've lived in the same house my entire life. Yay, a house, says my brother, when he's not thinking about video games. Okay, so when I was really little, probably about 2 or 3, my mom took me with her to the grocery store in that beautiful shopping cart that I drew, and I'm so little. And we were at the grocery store, obviously, so there was a bakery in the grocery store, and this lady at the bakery was handing out free cookie samples, and so she offers me one, and my mom's like, no, thank you, but the lady sneaks me a cookie anyway without my mom knowing, and I was like, oh yay, free cookie. But then, later on when we were driving home in our beautiful minivan, my mom started to hear me making these weird, like, choking sounds in the back seat. And I'm just coughing really bad, and she thinks there's a toy stuck in my throat or something, so she has to take me to the hospital. And lo and behold, the lady gave me a peanut butter cookie, and we discovered my severe allergy to nuts. So, that's good. Anyway, so when I grew up a little bit, when I was about 4 years old, I desperately wanted to be a dancer. So I brought my mom the phone book with the number to call a dance studio, and I begged her to make an appointment for me to take a class. And then ever since then, dance was my life. So when I started school, I was super excited, so I left school when I was younger, and I actually got into acting a little bit when I was in about the third grade. I was in a play called 1942 Christmas from Home at a local theater, but that didn't last long as a career. After elementary school, I moved to a Catholic school for middle school. It was kind of my choice. It was a better education, not necessarily for the religion. Yay, plaid! And I definitely had my middle school, 7th grade, whole awkward phase that everyone does. Except mine was a little different because I had a gap in my teeth and I had eczema, which is a severe, well, it was severe for me, skin condition. And I was just an awkward, weird kid. But who is in 7th grade, honestly? So, at the end of 6th grade, I'm going a little bit out of the order, but whatever. My family took an RV trip all around America. Rolling Turd, shout out to the movie RV. I was just like, okay with it, whatever. My mom was annoyed that we were taking an RV. My dad was excited about it. He's a photographer, but my parents both love to travel. And my brother was just like, video games. So we went. And we saw some pretty cool things. We went to the perimeter of the United States, basically. We saw Mount Rushmore, which is that beautiful drawing. We saw New York City for the first time. And we went to Disney, even though I'd been there before, and it was a really cool experience, even though being on an RV for a month wasn't that fun. Actually, it was more than a month. Anyway, so another trip we took was at the end of 7th grade, we went to Europe, and I was really, really reluctant. I didn't want to go, I just wanted to stay home with my friends, but I went because my parents made me, which everyone thought I was crazy. Even now, I look back and think I am too. But one day, we were in Italy, Florence, and we walked up the stairs inside, not outside, this Duomo, which is this giant, beautiful dome in Florence, and looking out over Italy really opened my eyes as to how beautiful it was and what a great opportunity I had. So from then on, I really enjoyed the trip. And one thing that was great about the trip is we actually took a cruise, and I made friends on the cruise, and I had a ton of fun. We went around Italy and Croatia, and I got to go to Venice, which was beautiful, and ride a gondola. And then after the cruise, we went on our own. I saw the Trevi Fountain and like the Eiffel Tower and everything like that. So in middle school, I never really talked about this, but I had a lot of body image problems and I was very unhealthy. I kind of had anorexic tendencies when I really didn't need to because I was completely healthy in middle school. And I was very compulsive about calories and stuff, which is really sad because I really didn't need to when I was really young. Anyway, so me and my friend Julia made our own YouTube channel in middle school where we made really random silly videos. We only made like 5, but we had fun doing it. So in 8th grade, things turned around a little bit for me. I grew out of my awkward phase a little bit and I started to kind of come out of my shell more. And I had a really great group of friends that I was really close to, and we had a lot of fun. And I became student body president that year, so that was really cool. And I just had a lot of fun in eighth grade, and it was a great year. And I noticed that the even number, like, grades are always better for me. I don't really know why. So after that, during the year, I kind of look back now and realize I was a little bit of a bully. I didn't think I was, but I would always try and be funny, and it was at the expense of other people sometimes, and I really regret the things that I said sometimes. Anyway, so after 8th grade, during the summer, I got my first job ever. Me and my friend Julia decided to work together as soon as I could legally, which was at age 14, and we got a job at a local restaurant. And basically what we did there is we were hostesses slash we worked behind the counter, so we would make coffee for people and seat them and scoop ice cream and sell things at the bakery. And oh, I also got involved with pageants in 8th and 9th grade. I did the local kind of preliminary, the county one of the Miss America pageant, and I had a lot of fun doing it. I was the runner-up the first year. And I made some great friends from it, and it was just a really good experience, and I got some scholarship money, so I don't regret it at all. So then comes high school, or high scod, as it looks like I wrote. Anyway, so going into high school, I was really awkward, and my 8th grade class was really, really small because I went from a Catholic school to a public high school, and I didn't really know anyone, so I basically just followed my friend Julia and her friends that she had already made around because she was a sophomore, and I just didn't really feel like I fit in. So then, later on, towards the end of the year, I met my friend Hannah, and she introduced me to a bunch of people, and I kind of found my niche after that, and found where I belonged, and I made a lot of great friends that I kind of clicked with, so that was a lot better for me. So then, actually, at the very end of 9th grade, I was looking up reviews for moisturizer online, and I found a video that All the Glitters 21 did. And then I was exposed to the wonderful world that is YouTube. So after watching videos for about a month, I decided to create a channel and start making videos in May of 2010. Great step in my life. And also that summer, I became a counselor in training at a summer camp that I've been going to since I was in third grade. And I loved the camp so much that I decided I wanted to be a counselor. So I still do that every summer to this day. Okay, so sophomore year. Things are a lot better for me this year because I had already kind of made some friends at the end of freshman year, so I had friends and I took better classes and I got involved more by doing clubs and activities at the school, and it was just a lot better for me. You know, I was happier and having more fun. And also sophomore year, a big step is me and my mom went to New York City in April for IMATS. It was the first IMATS that I'd been to, and it was so much fun. And this is when I really realized, like, the really great friendships I was able to make from YouTube and how lucky I was. And this is when I kind of established the best friends that I'll ever have. And I learned to drive at the end of sophomore year. Driver's ed, it was really boring, but I made it through the wilderness. I don't know why I said that. And then I got my license, and now I can drive, so that's good. And it was a big step for me because I love to drive. Also, at the end of summer, after sophomore year, my brother actually went off to college, so it was really weird for me because I'd always lived with him, and we kind of had to adjust. I was the only kid in the house, but he still likes video games. And after that, before junior year is when I really threw myself into YouTube and started taking it more seriously. I was doing videos consistently and really loving it. And I signed with a network, which is Style Hall, and YouTube really became the bigger part of my life. And junior year was junior year, nothing major. My classes were harder and it was a lot more intense. And I got my first B, which was a big deal back then, but now it's not really. Now, senior year, I had a lot of pressure in the beginning of the year because I had no idea where I wanted to go for college or what I wanted to do or anything, so it was kind of hard. And I never really talk about this because I like to come off as confident, which sometimes I am, but sometimes I'm not, but throughout high school I've dealt with my body image and fluctuating weight, but when I was younger I used to always have body image problems, but now I know that I really had no reason to, and it makes me angry that I was. And now, earlier this year, I started hearing back from colleges that I applied to, and I was really feeling on top of the world, but I kept getting these acceptance letters, and I was really excited because I applied to 11 schools, and then the school I wanted to go to didn't accept me, so it was really upsetting at the time, but now I think it's for the best because I think where I'm going is going to be perfect for me. And I officially committed to a college a few days ago, and I'll be going to college this fall in Southern California. So I'd like to use the end of this video to really thank you guys for all that you do for me, and I know this is so cliche and everyone says it, but I truly do not know what I would do without YouTube. And you guys are always there for me and offer me so much support and love, and I can always count on, you know, tweeting if I'm having a bad day and someone will help cheer me up, and it's really great, a support system that I love having. So thank you so much for watching my videos and supporting me and getting me to where I am today. So if you'd like to see more videos in depth of my life, I'm doing a throughout the year series on my vlog channel, youtube.com/morekristee. It'll be linked down below. You can follow me on Twitter if you would like to read my weird or strange tweets. And follow me on Tumblr if you really want to get to know the real me, which I'm not sure if you really will. But I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching me draw my life. Bye!